Hello there, my mate Vince here, aka Saturn Slayer, and today we're looking at another Sega Saturn. So I've taken over from the Switch killing days. Let's see this time if we can slay this one. I've actually had a lot of luck so far. I've only done two of them, and I've been successful both times. That's because both of them had a power supply issue, and it was the same chip that was faulty on both of them. And a guy called Richard watched that video, and I said at the end, I don't think I'll be doing any more Saturns, because the two that I've bought have both had the same problem, and it would have been more interesting if it was a problem with the motherboard. And he agreed, and he said that he's got six Saturns in various states, and some of them display to a black screen. Would I like to look at one? Hence the reason we've got this one here. And sure enough, you can see we definitely have power, but it's not doing anything. Let me just turn that off and do that again, because you can see it does something. So I'm off now, turning it on. It will go to there, and then nothing will come up whatsoever. Yeah. But yeah, if I put a disc in, I can definitely see that it is spinning up. So that appears to be working okay. I'm definitely tuned into the correct channel. I won't bother showing you, but I did it on my one there. That's one that I fixed in a previous episode. And 100% is tuned into the correct channel there. So yeah, why is it not outputting? I've just got it via RF out of this connection at the back here. So I think we'll start there, see if there's continuity between this side of the board and that side of the connector, and then maybe work in from there. I've never even had the main board out of one of these before, so it should be quite interesting. Let's get over to the mat and start looking at it. Right, first things first. Let me just see if there's any life left in this little coin battery back here. Yeah, 3.1 volts. So the battery is okay. Whoops, was okay. Right, let's take all the screws out and see what's happening on the inside. Right, so we know that there's power getting to the board because this light lights up here. I suppose what we could test, just in case, there's three different outputs on this power supply. So maybe it might have 12 volts going into the board, but it might not have the 5 volts and the 3.3 or whatever it is. I forget what it is now, but there's different voltages on here, and I can't actually see it marked up. I think the last one I did was marked up. This is a different layout than the one I had before. So I'm just going to plug it in, keep my hands well away from here, because this is AC here, which can obviously kill you. Right, plugging it in now. Now, let's turn it on. Ground on the bottom. Got 12 volts there. Second one down, 5 volts. Third one down, 5 volts. Oh, I thought it was a 5. 5. I thought there was one that was supposed to be 3. Hold on, is that a second one ground as well? Yes, it is. What's going on there? Right, let me just quickly Google what should be coming out here, because I'm wondering if it's pumping 5.5 out and it's 5.2 or whatever it was instead of 3.3, maybe that's the problem. Maybe the power supply is faulty again, even though we think it's going to be the board. Bear with me. It says here on one of the Reddit posts, it does say the later motherboards are 5 volt pins with no 3.3 volts. So if you put a Type C into a Type B console, then you put 5 volts into the SD RAM. So maybe this is just a later motherboard. Maybe the ones that I've looked at so far have been earlier ones. I suppose we have to take it as read that that's normal, because I mean, it is powering up. So let's forget about that for the moment. But yeah, I'm still not 100% sure about that. But anyway, let's just take it all apart and see if we can find anything obvious. That looks slightly burnt there, doesn't it? So we've got to undo the numerous screws that's dotted around this Sega Saturn, because we want to get to the actual board to see if we can find anything that looks like it might be the cause of this no display. Okay, we're in. We are in now. It's been recapped, hasn't it? Well, I'll double check that the caps are definitely put on the right way round. In fact, I can see a little plus on the board there. So that one's right. That one is
is correct, 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 and correct. Let's get it pulled out completely. I think let's start with, can we get onto the pins here? Let's start with here, just in case it's not doing the, just in case it's not going from here to here. Right, I'm just going to start on the top left and work my way through them all. Okay, that one's coming up there. Will these all test okay? There's continuity between every single hole and one of the solder pins on the board. So this connector is definitely not faulty. I was thinking maybe if it was dropped or something, there might be a lot of strain on this connector, but it all appears to be okay. Right, well, I don't think it's that. Let's zoom in and just have a little look around this area here. So what are all these things? What are they labeled up as? EM, so they're going to be little kind of filters, aren't they? And how many legs have they got? So they got three. As that goes to there, does it go to here? No, but it goes to here, which I presume then goes on. So let's say this one here, because we know that this goes to the little plug. Where does that go to? Here. And here. And here. Fine. So there's continuity basically from the edges. I'm just going to go across each of them. Right, okay, they're all okay. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to redo these capacitors. There's no point, I don't think there's any point in changing them over because they've been, you know, they have been redone. Maybe they were redone because it wasn't working. Rather than just like maintenance, maybe, you know, it was just let's change out the capacitors and it still didn't work. I'll be honest with you, I don't think this is going to be an easy fix. I think it's going to be a very, very time consuming one because I can't see any water damage or anything on the board. So unless there's something to do with these capacitors, which I very much doubt, I think it is going to be, I think it's going to take ages. So I'm just using a combination of the soldering iron, solder braid to wick up the old solder, and also my desolder station as well. And I've also replaced two more capacitors. So all the capacitors in this little section have been replaced. Some of them by the previous person and two of them by me. Luckily, there was no damage done. It looked a little bit messy. Some were a bit fragile, but I think what happened is they cut the old capacitors out. And in some instances, they just soldered on the new capacitors to the legs of the old ones, which is fine. Obviously, it's not quite as nice as just putting them through the holes. They're a little bit weaker, but good news is there was no damage to the board. So now I just need to give it a good clean up with some isopropyl alcohol, and then we can test it to see if it's going to work. As I say, I haven't got a clue whether this is the fault. I wouldn't be surprised if it starts working, but at the same time, I wouldn't be surprised if it didn't work. Because the thing is, although the soldering was a little bit fragile, as far as I could see, they were still all making a contact. So unless just changing these two out here has fixed the problem, I don't think it's going to work. Right, I've got it back together, but there's no screws in. Everything's just balanced. So, should be right though. Let's plug it in. I haven't turned this on yet. Let's see if anything happens. No. Okay. Right, let's turn that off, back on again. So it's the same as it was before. Yeah. So I'll take out the board again, and this time what I'm going to do, I'm going to get an ESR reading on all the caps, because maybe some of the original caps have gone faulty, and that's why we haven't got a display.
I mean, it looks like a third of them have been replaced, but what about all the other ones? Also, just before I do that, have a look at this. I noticed on the power supply that it is supposed to be 12 volts and 5 volts and 5 volts because it's actually labelled up underneath.
Can you see here it says 12 volts over here, 5.2 volts A and 5.2 volts B. So, and there you go, 5.2 volts B common. And 5.2 volts A common. So that's going to be the grounds. So, yeah, okay, we don't have to worry about that then. So it is supposed to be two lots of 5.2 volts and a 12 volt. So it is different voltages than the other board. And the other one, my other one was 9 volts. So this is 12 volts. So, yeah, it's all completely different. Well, at least we know that the fault is on the main board.
That's nice. Look at what I just noticed. Direction of wave soldering. So that's when the components, I mean, that's annoying if you have to take them apart. Basically, they're glued in position, and then this wave, imagine like a surfer's wave of solder comes over, and it basically just runs over the board from underneath, and it solders everything. I watched a little YouTube video on it. It looks amazing.
Okay, I've tested every single cap on here, and as far as I can see, they're all okay. So let's just, for example, take these four here. You can see negative is this side here. And if I was to go on them, you can see they all read the same. All very close to each other. Yep. So, yeah, as with the ESR meter, they look to be okay. Now, a couple of little things to note. I did find a resistor that was just barely hanging on, but I think it was probably to do with me when I was messing around with this capacitor here. So let me just zoom in. There's two things I want to show you. That little resistor there, I had to just solder back on because it was basically fractured. It was just hanging on one side but not the other. And that does go to that leg there off that capacitor. So there's a chance that might not have been me, but I think it was. The other thing that I thought looked quite strange is, you see this cable here, which goes up to, that goes up to the little board, doesn't it? That goes up to the board for the disc. And if you have a look at the pins at the bottom, we have a massive solder bridge. And then they go across these coils here. Now the coils are testing okay from here to here. And also, yeah, here to here, I think it was. But should we have that one bridge? Because look, it's bridging to ground. I mean, this is ground here. I presume that's completely normal. But then again, would that side there be? So that means that side there is going to now be ground. I wonder, is that normal? You know what I'm going to do? Just to see, I am going to unsolder that. Just in case it's not, factory. I think it is, because it looks perfect. But just in case there was a drip of solder that dripped down, that wasn't me, I don't think, but it could have happened when the replacement capacitors were done. So I'm just going to try to separate that. Right, let's just leave that separated. Just to see, I'll leave it a mess like that because it's going to get soldered up again. I'm just wondering, why has it got a blob like that? Again, would it make a difference if it's going up to... Well, maybe. Maybe it's put in some sort of... you think the disc would not work, though, rather than not display. I don't think that's anything to do with it, but they're the only things I've spotted. So I'm going to plug it back in and see if it's changed. Well, surprise, surprise, there's no difference. So, let's get back to the mat. Another failure. So I am going to rebridge this because I think it was bridged from the factory and it doesn't actually make a difference to whether it works or not. So let's just rebridge that. I can always unbridge it again later. What I'm going to say now, I don't think I'm going to be able to fix this. I think it's going to be a chip that's failed. I don't think I'm going to be able to find out what chip it is. Right, what I'm going to do now is I am going to look around the board and see if I can see any maybe cold solder joints or anything like that. I'm going to be looking very closely through my eye loop here. And I don't really know where to go because, I mean, there's just chips everywhere. I'm slightly concerned that it's been reflowed everywhere. I don't know, there just seems to be markings, but maybe that's normal. There you go, that's an example of the wave soldering. Can you see there? A lump of red glue. So if you were to try to take this chip off, you really would struggle, because you've got to, not only have you got to unsolder it, you've got to then get more heat into it or try to pry it off because of the glue. Well, I'll get back to this in a bit. Hopefully, if I look closely, I might be able to see something. I can see some crystals. Maybe I could get my scope connected up and see whether we have anything at these crystals. Maybe we don't. Right, slightly excited. It just shows you that your eyes are the best tool, apart from maybe IPA. Look in here, I can see a little bit of corrosion. Weird thing is, I don't know where it's come from, because on the other side, there's no capacitors or anything like that. So I don't quite know why it's just landed in the middle of the board. Now, it might not be deep, it might not be anything. Once I clean it with IPA, it might be gone, but I just want to show it to you, because really, everything else that I've seen so far looks good, but I haven't gone over the whole board, but this definitely doesn't look good. Let me zoom right in. It's just here. Right, so this whole area here does definitely look a little bit corroded, doesn't it? But let's clean it with IPA, because it might be just some kind of weird flux. But often when you see those black marks there, that means that the trace is completely eaten through. And also, it's in the vias as well. I'll show you the other side, because the other side looks dirty as well. So for example, there might not be continuity going through this one here. And I mean, that goes from this chip onwards. I just don't know why it's happened in the middle of the board here. You know, it's nowhere near a battery, nowhere near a capacitor. It's just weird for it to happen here. Right, well, I definitely need to look at that more, don't I? Now, let's go to the other side of that, the other side of the board, which will be, where's my finger? Here, can you see here? Funny enough, a lot of these do go down to where the capacitors are. From here, it goes down, 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 and you see this is where the capacitors are around this area. I mean, I'd be very surprised if that's not gone through here. Right, should we start on this side then? Should we do a little bit? Let me get my grinding tool. Let's grind away a little bit of the solder mask from here and here, and let's see if we have continuity through it. Right, I think that should be enough. This side. Right, please let there not be continuity. Don't need to worry about this one, that looks good, but let's just see if we have got something. That's good. That's good. Please let this not be good. No, it's here. What? I thought that was going to be it. How about this one? No way, you're here. You're here. Yeah, here, no way. I thought that would have, I thought they would have gone through. Look at the rust. Do you know what though? It's a via. Maybe it's not going from one side of the board to the other. Look at the rust on it. You know what I mean? It might not be going through the board. Although we've got continuity on this side, it might not be going from here through the board. I think those wires have rusted out. Unless I'm just eating away at the fiberglass off the board, but I don't think so. I think we can safely say that we're not going to have continuity through there now. So let's see. No, so we haven't got it through there now.
See, although there was continuity, it doesn't mean that it was going to be making a good connection. Right, okay, so I need to obviously do work here. And now let's go to the other side of the board and grind away a little bit. Yeah, so if the vias have gone, we're not going to get from the chip to the other side of the board. I'm just going to grind away here. I know it looks very destructive, but I have to, you know, get rid of this corrosion anyway, don't I? Right, let's go from the chip forwards. So we have this one here, and it's here, yeah? Right, so that is getting to there. Let's go to the next one. Here. Yes, it's getting there. This one. No, but that's probably because I was doing the grinding. So we need to put a wire through the board there to connect up both sides. The vias look quite big, those holes, so I should be okay. I think I'm going to say that this is the fault, because the rest of the board looks good and the person just changed out the capacitors because they probably watch YouTube videos and stuff, and often, like the Game Gear, people just say that because something's old you have to change the capacitors out. Now maybe these capacitors are known to fail. It's a common thing that will get something working if they're faulty when they get to a certain age. But I think in this instance here, I don't think it had anything to do with capacitors. I would say, I'm hoping, is to do with this bit here. So what I need to do is get some tiny enameled wire. I'm going to start with this. This is like 0.3 off a mil. I want to see if this will fit through the holes, or is it far too big?
So I know it doesn't look it, but there is actually easily a couple of hours work here, I would say. It's amazing how time consuming this is, but it is good fun. It's nice, you know, remaking something, because then you're thinking, okay, this will hopefully fix it. So what I'm doing is I'm trying to place a wire from one side to another. I hope this isn't a multi-layer board. I hope it's just top layer and bottom layer. If it's a multi-layer board, I've kind of had it, unless just by luck the solder will flow through the via along with the wire and then join up everything. But I'm thinking a board this age would just be the top layer and the bottom layer, so I think it would be okay. And I've been blessed with nice big via, so it's easy to put this wire through. So if this wire has got enamel coating on, so I'm going to have to use a soldering iron with some solder to burn off the enamel coating, otherwise I'm not going to be able to solder very well with it. And yeah, it's just a case of basically trying to repatch all these things up. What makes it harder is the vias, because I have to put the wire through the via, but also connect up either side of the via on this side and the other side. So there's going to be some folding off the wire. Otherwise, I'm just going to have to end up doing loads of separate little runs on the one track. So yeah, anyway, while I'm doing that, I'll give a shout out to the My Mate Vince Massive. And this month the members are kitdigital.com, Kip Hakes, and Max Rokotansky. Having Fun Repairs, Chris Seal, Felipe at MrKeebs.com, DJVG, Pigsy, Robert from Timsey's Auto Air, Daniel Watson, Zeke's C, Anthony Dean, Bazza 2, Russ Melanson, Ellis Garbutt, Gaspar Heller, Richard Berglund and Jacob Culpin. Massive thank you guys for supporting these videos, along with everybody else on Patreon, and along with everybody else that shares their knowledge. And with that sharing of knowledge, we all learn, not just me, but everybody else who reads those comments. So a massive thank you. Great little repair community spirit going on in these videos. And bit by bit, hopefully more and more people will get into fixing once they see that you don't have to be an expert all the time to get things working. So as you can see, I've soldered up this one now on both sides. I've got about another, I would hazard a guess at maybe 4 or 5 to do. So I'm going to do that off camera and then I'll show you the end result. I won't put any solder mask on it just yet, because I want to make sure that it is actually working. And then once it's working, we can put the solder mask on, and hopefully this will be a lasting repair, because we've got rid of the corrosion and now we've run new wire. So the signals can travel all down the same tracks that they did originally. Right, so you can see that we've got it to here. Yeah.
and we have to have the other side because it's a wire that hasn't been broken. So I'm not going to start going to the other side, but you can see that the wire's from here to here and it's already intact to here. So now I'm going to do the same with all the other ones, and then hopefully at the end it will be it will probably look a complete mess, but I'm hoping that might work. You never know. Right, I'll probably see you in about an hour or two. Right, I am finished. Took a good hour, probably about an hour 15 minutes. So I haven't put any conformal coating or anything on it, and I also haven't checked to see whether or not it goes from the legs of the chip to the other side of the board. But what I've done is I've put the wires through where I think they need to go. But if you have a listen now, you can hear, and they're not shorting either, so just take my word for it that they're not shorting to each other, even though the reflections might look like they are. Yeah, and you can see here, for example, I went through the board, I think here and here, and also I think on one of them as well. And sometimes I had to double over. So if I turn it over now, I had to go down to some thinner wire on some of them. Where am I? Here. So basically, can you see here, I looped it over. So the wire comes through the wire is completely gone here. And then I soldered it here, looped it over, soldered it here. I think I did the same on this one here, that's looped over. And again, I think it's going to be okay. So what I'm going to do is, it's late at night, so I can't be yelling. Do you know what? I haven't felt the need to yell yes in a long time. It's like right now, you see, I'm expecting this to work. So all I'm really getting is disappointment when it's not working. Yeah, I haven't had a fix where it's suddenly like, oh my God, yes, it's working, like, you know, where I get really excited. So I hope I'm not losing the passion. I think it's just because right now, years ago, I would have been over the moon if this started to work. But right now, I'm expecting it to work because there's corrosion. And I think now it will work. So basically, if it works, I'm not going to be surprised. If it doesn't work, I'm going to be disappointed.
Right, here goes. I have to whisper. We're on the crack channel. Come on now. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Yes! Actually, I did get more excited than I thought because I didn't think that was going to work because of the pause. Yes! Look at that! Fantastic! Right, okay. Good, 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 good. I haven't lost the passion yet. Now let's see, is that going to load up? It's spinning. Now what do I have to do here? Should we go to English? Exit. Let's just go through all that, don't care about that. Come on, let's see if it will load. Oh, look at that. Oops, sorry, hold on.
Well, I'll do a voiceover for this little bit here. Basically, it's displaying, and every time I turn this on, it is displaying, so that bit's fixed. But it's not playing the discs. It's really weird. It plays the audio from the discs, like the music tracks, but yet it doesn't play the game. So I think it might be a problem with the security side of things. So what I do, this is just mostly off, well, I'm gonna end this video now, basically. What I do in the next hour is, I take the disc drive out of the working Sega Saturn and I put it in this one and it still doesn't work. Then I take the faulty disc drive out of this Saturn and put it in the working Saturn and it works. So we know the drive itself isn't faulty. So this is what I'm thinking. This video is about trying to fix the no display, and I'm going to do a separate video on trying to fix the fact that it will play audio CDs but not the game, because that is really, really odd. So let me just finish up this video now with a little bit of footage from the next day.
Right, it's the next day now and it is always displaying, so it doesn't matter how much I turn it off and on again, it will always give me a display. But it just keeps coming up with this audio thing here where it allows me to play the audio side of the games, but it doesn't allow me to play the game. So I think it's to do with some sort of security thing that's not passing. So it will say check in disc format and then watch this, there you go, it comes up with it. So yeah, really, really strange.
I'm going to call it a day because I think I've got enough footage, and also I've managed to pull some weird muscle in my leg when I was trying to get a mosquito that was plaguing me. Annoyingly, the mosquito lived, but now I'm hobbling around the place, so I just want to edit this up. I can't move around much today. I just want to get this video edited, get it live, and then I can concentrate on the next one. The next one can be called Trying to Fix a Sega Saturn That Plays Audio But Doesn't Play Games, because I'm sure it's going to happen to many other people, rather than trying to cram everything into this one video. What I did do last night is, let me just turn that off and unplug everything so it's safe to open. Whoops. Oh, didn't take the disc out first. I was playing around with this potentiometer. So we know that this is working because I tried it in the other one, and the other working one in here still didn't work. But what I thought is maybe on the board, if there were some capacitors going weak, that if I was to up the gain on this little potentiometer down here, then maybe the laser would start working. So what I did is I turned it completely to the left, and basically it wouldn't read the discs. And then as I was turning it to the right, if you can imagine, it kind of gone from maybe 7 o'clock all the way around to 4 or 5 o'clock, so that's how much room there is to play. Yeah, and from 7 o'clock to midnight it doesn't play the discs, and then from midnight to 5 o'clock then it will only play the audio side of it. So obviously I must have changed the gain on that, and it still wasn't working. So there's definitely something on the board that's not allowing it to work. So I think we need to tackle that in the next episode. If you've got any ideas, please put it down to the comments below. I will do plenty of research on Google, and hopefully we'll be able to get this fully working next time. But the original thought was that it didn't display, and we got that working because of all that corrosion in the middle of the board. So yeah, I thought that was quite interesting. Hopefully you enjoyed the video. Massive thanks to Richard for sending this out to me. And yeah, I'll get another video out of this as well, which is great. Stay tuned for that one. Hopefully that will be out now in the next few days. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you all very soon.